So one of the first things you're going to want to learn how to do when you're just learning how to play is learn how to tune your guitar. It's very important. Even if you're doing all the right things, if your guitar is out of tune, you're going to sound terrible. So, and you're going to want to check to make sure your guitar is in tune pretty much every time you pick it up. So always kind of check that. Now, the best way to tune your guitar is using a, probably the easiest way is to use a tuner. You can buy a guitar tuner from a music store or a guitar store. Or if you're a geek like me, you can download an application for your iPhone or your iPod Touch. This one is called the Guitar Toolkit. It's got a built-in tuner. It's got a built-in metronome and some guitar chord charts and all kinds of cool stuff. So Guitar Toolkit's what that's called, if you're interested. If you don't have either of those, you can go to the resources section of the activemelody.com website, and there's an online tuner. So you can click the little green play buttons and get all the tones for each of the six strings and just match yours up to those. In fact, I use that one myself all the time. However, if you don't have any of those, which is common, if you're out playing somewhere and your guitar gets knocked out of tune or doesn't sound right, you can tune it to itself. And let me show you how to do that. So what you do is you need to try and get, if you can, try and get an A note. So if there's a piano nearby where you can get an A note, or another guitar player is around or something, you gotta have something as a reference. If you don't have anything, you're just going to have to guess. But try and get as close as you can. Now, I can't do that. I don't have a perfect pitch where I can just kind of hear a note out of thin air. Most people can't do that. So once you get one note, you can get all the rest. So if you can get that A note, then all you got to do is on the fifth fret, fifth string, push down, and you're creating the D note, which is the open fourth string, which is the note of the string above that. So you can see how those two match. That's your reference. That's the note you're trying to match to. So if the fourth string's out of tune, you'll hear it. You just got to twist it till they match. And that's how you do that. Now, moving on to the next string, you're going to go to the fourth string, fifth fret, also on the fifth fret, and that's going to give you the G note, which is the open third string, which is the string above it. So those two should match. So that's your reference. And again, if your G note's a little out of tune, you just kind of twist it until you get it right. Now, those two were on the fifth fret. The next one is actually on the fourth fret. So we're going to go to the third string, fourth fret, and that creates the B note, which is the open second string. So those need to match. So fifth fret, fifth fret, fourth fret. Now we'll go back to get the high E. We're going to push down on the fifth fret, second string, and those two should match. So it's fifth fret, fourth fret, fifth fret. And you can look at the I should have the tablature for you on that as well, so you can make sure that you're doing that right. But that's what I mean by, if you can get one note right, you can get all the rest of them. Now, to get the low E string or the sixth string, what I do is I always listen to the high E string, and since they're an exact octave of each other, I just try and match it up that way. So if it's out, let's kind of tune it until it slides into place. And you're always going to want to go from the bottom up, by the way. You're never going to want to go down, because sometimes some extra tension can be left in the string. So it's always best to go up to the tune, up to the note, like that. So once you get all your strings in tune by using that reference system, you're good to go. Like I said, if you don't have any way to get any of the notes right, you can just kind of guess. And obviously, there would be no other instruments around, and you'd just be playing along with yourself, so that should be fine. There wouldn't be anybody to notice that something was wrong. So that's how you tune your guitar.